continue that life of Jonah. Jonah part 3. Okay, let's read Jonah chapter 3 verses 1 and 2. Jonah chapter 3 verse 1 and 2.
Now the word of the Lord came to Jonah the second time saying, "Arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and preach to it the message that I tell you."
Amen. Here the Bible says, verse 1, Bible says, "Now the word of the Lord came to Jonah the second time saying." Okay, already God spoke to Jonah. Okay, we can see the first time when the word came to Jonah. Jonah chapter 1, verses 1 and 2. Verse 1 and 2.
Mm. "Now the word of the Lord came to Jonah, the son of Amittai, saying, Arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and cry out against it, for their wickedness has come up before me."
First time the word came to Jonah, God told Jonah, "Arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and cry out against it, for their wickedness has come up before me." The first time the word came to Jonah, but he avoided, he rejected the word of God. He disobeyed. God asked him to go to Nineveh, but he did not go to Nineveh. He went to Tarshish. Now Bible says chapter 3 verse 1, second time. Again, the word of the Lord came to Jonah the second time saying, verse 2. Mm.
"Arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and preach to it the message that I tell you."
Second time also, God is telling the same thing to Jonah. Amen. Hallelujah. Our God is God of second chance. Amen. Hallelujah. Even though Jonah went away from God's presence, even though Jonah disobeyed, amen, God was waiting for Jonah to come back. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. God did not choose someone else to give that message. God was waiting for Jonah. Amen. He was in the fish belly for 3 days. Okay. He went away from the presence of God. But still, God was waiting for Jonah. Amen. Hallelujah. That is the good news. We can have it. God of second chances. Amen. Many times, we miss the chance. Right? Jonah missed it. God asked him to go to Nineveh. Okay, but he did not go. But again, Bible says, second time, God spoke to Jonah. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. In our life also, we need this grace. Hallelujah. God wants to do certain things through you only. For that, God will wait. Amen. Hallelujah. If you read John chapter 21, John chapter 21, verse 1-3.
"After these things, Jesus showed himself again to the disciples at the Sea of Tiberias, and in this way he showed himself. Simon Peter, Thomas called the twin, Nathanael of Cana in Galilee, the son of Zebedee, and two others of his disciples were together. Simon Peter said to them, 'I am going fishing.' They said to him, 'We are going with you also.' They went out and immediately got into the boat, and that night they caught nothing."
Amen. Here the Bible talks about Simon Peter. After Jesus resurrected, Simon Peter told, "I am going for fishing." Okay, Jesus touched his life. Jesus asked him to follow him. He left everything. He started to follow Jesus. Okay, now Jesus died. They did not know what they are going to do the next morning. Amen. Hallelujah. They knew one thing, Jesus resurrected. But they did not know what they are going to do for their life. That's why Peter said, "I am going for fishing." Okay, whatever he left, he wanted to do it again. But the good news, Jesus did not want to lose Peter. Jesus wanted to give him second chance. Bible says, for that purpose, Jesus appeared to the disciples again. Hallelujah. For one Peter, he visited Again, already Jesus appeared to the disciples. Disciples knew he resurrected. Jesus was resurrected. But again, now Peter was telling, I am going for fishing. Hallelujah. Thomas was waiting for this golden opportunity. Okay, somebody has to say something. If somebody goes, I can also go. If Peter goes for fishing, I can also go. So again, seven people, they were decided to go for fishing. Amen. Hallelujah. But Bible says they caught nothing. Sometimes the nothing is good. Hallelujah. Amen. Sometimes nothing is good. Sometimes the lack is good for our good. Hallelujah. If they caught lot of fish that night, definitely they would go back for fishing business. Amen. Hallelujah. Sometimes God will allow you to go through some lackness, some shortage, some emptiness. Why? It's for our good. Hallelujah. That means He needs you. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Sometimes God is allowing us to go through financial crisis. Why? He needs your attention. He needs you. Then only you will pray. Amen. Hallelujah. But the good news is Jesus visited them. Hallelujah. They all backslided. They said, we are going for fishing. No need to go and visit them, right? If Jesus can choose 12 more disciples, he can choose. If Jesus wants to choose some other people, he can choose. Amen, right? But Jesus needed Peter. Hallelujah. Jesus needed other disciples too. Okay, this man, this Peter, making a lot of influence on others. So I need to touch this person first. If I touch him, everybody will be in the same line. Amen. Hallelujah. So Jesus appeared to them. Verse 4.
But when the morning had now come, Jesus stood on the shore. Yet the disciples did not know that it was Jesus.
Verse 5.
Then Jesus said to them, children, have you any food? They answered him, no.
Hallelujah. How Jesus called them? Children. Hallelujah. If you and me in that place, how would you call? Would you call children? No. Hey, backsliders. Right? Or backstabbers. I trusted you all, but you showed your back towards me. You put me down. You went away from me. Right? We will give different names. Peter, you are the reason. Hallelujah. But Jesus said, children, when you go away from the Lord, the Father's heart will cry out to you and it will call you my child. My child, I want to give you a visitation. I need you. Amen. Hallelujah. Next verse.
And he said to them, cast the net on the right side of the boat and you will find some. So they cast, and now they were not able to draw it in because of the multitude of fish.
Hallelujah. Jesus can perform a miracle for the backslider also. Hallelujah. Amen. But we should understand why he wants to do the miracle for the backsliders. To come back. To come back to Jesus. To pull their attention towards Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Not to take the fish and to go back. To come back to Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Jesus loves you. He can do a miracle for you also. Maybe you are thinking, I am going away from the presence of God. I am not in the love of God. Today, this morning, He wants to do a miracle in your life so that you can come back to Jesus. Hallelujah. He gave the strategy to the disciples. Cast the net the other side. Then you will catch some fish. But Bible says they caught lot of fishes. Hallelujah. Then he asked them to have the food first. Verse 13.
Jesus then came and took the bread and gave it to them, and likewise the fish.
Okay. We can read verse 9 also.
Then as soon as they had come to land, they saw a fire of coals there and fish laid on it and bread.
Jesus already prepared a breakfast for the backsliders. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Your miracle is in the shore, not in the sea. You don't need to go back for fishing. If you can, if you decide to stand on the shore, the fish will come to the shore. Amen. Do you understand? What Peter thought? What Peter thought? I need to trust this fishing business again. Let me go back and fishing. But what Jesus did? Peter, your fish is in the shore. You can find the fish in the shore also. Can you find the fish in the shore? No. You can find the fish in only in ocean. But if you follow Jesus, you can find the fish in the shore also. Amen. Hallelujah. What kind of fish? Grilled fish. Amen. Hallelujah. It says like that, right? Verse 9.
Then as soon as they had come to land, they saw a fire of coals there and fish laid on it and
okay.
bread.
The fish is on the coal. Fire. Fire of coal. Grilled fish is waiting for you. Why you need to go for the raw fish? You need to clean up. You need to put all the spicy things. You need to prepare it. You don't need to do anything. If you trust Jesus, if you decide to follow Jesus, everything will be ready for you in the shore. Amen. Who will put the grill for you? Jesus will put the grill for you. Amen. Hallelujah. Peter, you are looking for fish, but I can make a bread also for you. Amen. You are looking for one thing and you are going away from me, but I can prepare two more things for you. Hallelujah. That is love of Jesus Christ. Amen. That's why he wants to give you the second chance. God gave a second chance to Peter. Amen. Jesus appeared to Peter. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Even though the fish was ready in the shore, but he gave the strategy to Peter and other disciples, cast your net other side. Why he did that? Why he did that? I am the same miracle working God yesterday, today and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. He wanted to remind them, hey, I am not a dead God. I died, I resurrected, I am a living God. Amen. Yesterday I provided you, or few months before, I performed the same miracle, Peter, to you. Amen. God performed the same miracle. I am an unchanging God. Hallelujah. I am same yesterday, today and forever. How many of you believe that? Amen. If you believe that, you will stick on to Jesus. Hallelujah. You will never go back from Jesus. Hallelujah. You are having a same miracle working God. Amen. Hallelujah. 10 years before, if he is able to give you visa, he is able to give you the visa extension today. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Don't put your trust upon your visa. Put your trust upon Jesus. Hallelujah. He knows how to do it. He knows how to perform the miracle. Amen. Hallelujah. Pastor, we got the green card. We don't need to worry. Hallelujah. Rules are changing. Anytime it can be invalid. Yes. Amen. If you put your trust upon the green card, it can go away. Put your trust upon Jesus. Not on the green card, not on the citizenship. Amen. Our citizenship is in the heaven. Hallelujah. Yes. Amen. Yes. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. One who led you so far, he is able to lead you continuously. Amen. Okay. Next verse. John 21:10.
Jesus said to them, bring some of the
fish
which you have just caught. Simon Peter went up and dragged the net to land full of large fish, 153. And although there were so many, the net was not broken. Jesus said to them, come and eat breakfast. Yet none of the disciples dare ask him, who are you? Knowing that it was the Lord.
Now they knew it's the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Because they saw the miracle again. They knew only Jesus can do like this. Amen. Only Jesus can call us children. Even though we are backsliding, only he can alone call us children. That's why they knew this is the Lord. Amen. Only Jesus can show the love like this, preparing a breakfast for us, even though we are backsliding. That's why they knew this is the Lord. That's why no one asks, who are you? Amen. We don't need to ask also. Breakfast is fine. That's it. Why we need to ask, who are you? But they knew that is Jesus. Only Jesus can do like this. That's the love of God. Amen. Hallelujah. What he said, come and eat breakfast. Amen. First eat, then I will deal with you. Amen. If we are in the place of Jesus, what will say? First question, first thing, what will say? Why you went for fishing again? We won't say, come and eat breakfast. We want to settle the things first. Why you went? Peter, you are the reason. Because of you, all this guy followed you. Amen? Hallelujah. First settle the things, then eat the breakfast. But the love of Jesus is different. Come and eat. Amen? I know you are hungry. I know you are worried about your tomorrow. I know how to provide your needs. Amen? Come and eat. Next verse.
Jesus then came and took the bread and gave it to them and likewise
the fish. Next verse.
This is now the third time Jesus showed himself to his disciples after he was raised from the dead.
Next verse.
So when they had eaten breakfast, Jesus said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of Jonah, do you love me more than this?
See, who was Simon Peter?
Son of Jonah.
Right. Who is Jonah?
Jonah was the one. God.
Who was Jonah? Went away from the presence of God. Simon, who was? Son of Jonah. Amen? Amen. Who are we? Son of Jonas. Amen? Yes. Hallelujah. Many times we did not recognize, realize the miracles of Jesus Christ in our life. We are ready to go away from the presence of God. That's why Jesus said, now Jesus is asking the question, do you love me more than this? Hallelujah. He said to him, yes, Lord. Okay, when Jesus asked, after the breakfast, he will do the miracles, but he will not leave you just like that. Amen? If he does miracles in your life, that means he will expect more from your life.
Amen?
Amen? Don't think that just I can enjoy the miracles and go away like that. No, he will not leave you like that. Amen? Hallelujah. Do you love me? That's a question. That means if you love me, you will never go like this. If you love me, you will stand with me. If you love me, you will not go back. Hallelujah. Amen? Amen? So our basic, our foundation should be in the love of God. Should be with the love of God. Hallelujah. If we love Jesus, we will never go back. That's why Jesus asks, do you love me? Amen. How many times Jesus asked? Then 3 times Jesus asked Peter, do you love me? Do you love me? Do you love me? Amen. Hallelujah. Then Jesus told him, follow me. Hallelujah. We can read verse 19. Sorry. 19.
This he spoke, signifying by what death he would glorify God. And when he had spoken this, he said to him, follow me.
Jesus asked him 3 times, do you love me? Then Jesus prophesied over his life. Then Jesus told him, follow me. Hallelujah. Love me, follow me. Hallelujah. When you have love upon Jesus, you will follow Jesus. Amen. When you follow Jesus, you will never backslide. Amen. Your eyes will be upon Jesus. You will never think about the fish. You will never think about the bread. It will be in the shore. Amen. Whoever loves God, he is able to take care of everything. Amen. Romans chapter 8, verse 28. Amen. If you love God, all things are happening for your good. Hallelujah. Amen. That's why Jesus asked Peter, do you love me? Then Jesus said, follow me. Hallelujah. Today, Jesus wants to visit our life one more time. Hallelujah. He wants to ask us this question. Do you love me? Hallelujah. Will you follow me? When you agree to do, everything will be taken care. How many of you believe that He is Jehovah Jireh? Hallelujah. He is Jehovah Jireh in your life. He knows what you need. Hallelujah. Everything will be available in the shore. You don't need to get into the ocean again. Hallelujah. Whatever you left for the Lord, let it be like that. Don't go back. Don't go back. Hallelujah. You will get it in the shore itself. Amen. Do you understand what I say? Amen. Hallelujah. If you left something for the Lord's namesake, everything will be taken care of in the presence of God. Hallelujah. Okay, come back to Jonah. Jonah chapter 3 verse 4. Chapter 3 verse 2.
Arise, go to Nineveh.
Okay, verse 1 says God spoke to Jonah again. Second chance coming to Jonah. Verse 2.
Arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and preach to it the message that I tell you.
Okay, second time God visited Jonah, second time God is speaking to Jonah. But the one thing we need to notice here, God did not change the message. Message was same, right? First time, what the message He gave to Jonah, the same message He is giving to Jonah again. God knew Jonah did not like the message. Right? God can visit you 100 times, but God will never change His message. Hallelujah. God will not compromise with you. Do you understand? God knew Jonah did not like this message because God is asking him to go to Nineveh. Hallelujah. Sometimes we may think like that. Okay, He is my son, He is my prophet, He is my servant. If you are in the place of God, how you will think, okay, my son does not like this message. Let me give a different message. Let me give a different assignment. Okay, Jonah, you don't want to go to Nineveh. Okay, go to Tarsus. Go and preach. No, God will never compromise. Hallelujah. You need to come back to God. God won't come back to you. You need to change your mind. You need to change your heart. You need to come and align with God. Many times we are expecting God to change His mind. God to come according our desires. Hallelujah. Lord, already I told you I will not go to Nineveh. Don't give me the message again. No. You cannot resist God. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank God for He was waiting for Jonah. If He wanted to choose someone else, He can do that. Hallelujah. He was waiting for Jonah. He was visiting Jonah again. But the thing we need to see here, He did not change His message. Again He told, you have to go to Nineveh. Whether you like it or not, you have to go. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. He has a second choice to visit you. But He does not have a second option to change His message. Do you understand? Amen. He will be stick on to that. Okay. How many times you are going away, go. But when you come back, I will tell the same thing. Go to Nineveh. Once you go to Nineveh, then assignment done. Hallelujah. Amen. Until you come back to God and say, Lord, here I am. He will give you the same assignment again and again and again and again and again. One way it's good. One way it's good because you are going to fulfill the heart of God. You are going to fulfill the will of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Okay. God said, go to Nineveh again. Verse 3.
So Jonah arose and went to Nineveh according to the word of the Lord. Now Nineveh was an exceedingly great city, a 3-day journey in extent.
Amen. So Jonah arose and went in. Thank God this time he obeyed. Amen. He did not want to go through the stormy experiences. He did not want to go into the fish belly again. He come down and he came down and he said, yes, Lord, I will go. Amen. Yes. So the stormy experiences was his good. Amen. So the fish belly experience was for his good. Amen. Now he came back and said, "Yes, Lord, I will go." And he started to preach. Next verse, verse 4.
And Jonah began to enter the city on the first day's walk. Then he cried out and said, "Yet 40 days and Nineveh shall be overthrown."
Next verse.
So the people of Nineveh believed God, proclaimed a fast, and put on sackcloth from the greatest to the least of them.
Amen. Bible says he went and preached. What kind of preaching he did? In 40 days, Nineveh will be destroyed. That's it. Gone. Right? It's not the good message. It's a bad message. It's a sad message. Hallelujah. Jesus loves you, it's easy to preach. Jesus will destroy you, it's very difficult to preach. Amen? Right? Hallelujah. But the messenger cannot change the message. Whatever the message comes from above, the messenger has to preach. Then only that preaching will work. Hallelujah. What the people did? Immediately, they started to fast. Hallelujah. When you preach the word of God without changing, only that message will work in the life of people. Hello? Amen? We cannot become boss to God. Lord, this message is not good. How people will recognize me? I am in their town. I am going to preach to them. And then I am going to say to them, you will be destroyed. In how many days? 40 days. Hallelujah. They will kill me the next day, Lord. At least they can live 40 days. They will kill me the same day. I cannot live 40 days also, right? But Jonah preached whatever God asked him to preach. Amen. Hallelujah. When God gives you some message, when God tells you to do something, do not mix up with your own ideas. You cannot become God to God. Hallelujah. God is God. You are just a messenger. Whatever he tells you, you need to go and tell. Amen. But make sure you are receiving a message from God. Amen. That is a very important thing. Without God telling anything, if you go and tell them within 40 days you will be destroyed, they will destroy you in 1 minute. Hallelujah. That's why we need to make sure, am I receiving a message from God? Am I carrying the word of God? Amen. Hallelujah. Okay. They started to repent. Next.
Then word came to the king of Nineveh, and he arose from his throne and laid aside his robe, covered himself with sackcloth, and sat in ashes.
Next verse.
And he caused it to be proclaimed and published throughout Nineveh by the decree of the king and his nobles, saying, "Let neither man nor beast, herd nor flock, taste anything. Do not let them eat or drink water. But let man and beast be covered with sackcloth and cry mightily to God. Yes, let everyone turn from his evil way and from the violence that is in his hands."
Amen. See, one backslider, one person who went away from the presence of God, when he came back to God, he is able to use that person powerfully. Jonah went away from the presence of God. Completely he disobeyed. But God used the same tool to touch the lives of people in the Nineveh, city of Nineveh. Amen. The reason he came back to God. He obeyed to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. God wants to use you again. Amen. Maybe you went away from the Lord. Maybe you are, or the people, those are watching through the streaming, maybe you are thinking, I'm completely gone. Whether God can use me again? Yes. If you come back to the Lord, He is able. Amen. Hallelujah. Your life will become effective to touch many lives. Amen. Because of this Jonah preaching, the city of Nineveh, they came back to God. The king said, "Let us look to God. Maybe He will change His heart." Okay, verse 10.
Then God saw their works, that they turned from the evil way, and God relented from the disaster that He had said He would bring upon them, and He did not do it.
Amen. The whole nation came back to God. That's why God changed His heart. Let me not destroy this nation. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. How God changed His heart? because of the people repentance. Whenever you come back to God, his heart will change. Whenever you repent from your evil ways, his heart will change. Amen. Repentance has power. Gospel has power. Amen. Hallelujah. They all came back to God. God changed his heart. The whole nation. Amen. If you are Jonah, how you would feel? Thank God. Through one sermon, the entire nation came back to the Lord. Hallelujah. Lord, thank you for using me. Even though I went away from your presence, you used me. Amen. That's the way we should think, right? But what happened in the life of Jonah? Chapter 4, verse 1.
But it displeased Jonah exceedingly.
But it displeased Jonah
exceedingly.
Hallelujah. Amen. It displeased Jonah exceedingly and he became angry. Amen. In Tamil version it says he became very angry. Hallelujah. He displeased. Hallelujah. I don't care whether 120,000 people are coming back to you or not. I want, my word needs to be fulfilled. Hallelujah. Jonah was very selfish. Hallelujah. Why he became upset? Because he wanted, his words needs to be fulfilled. Hallelujah. You can see the next verse.
So he prayed to the Lord and said, Our Lord,
now he is praying.
Was not this what I said when I was still in my country? Therefore I fled previously to Tarshish, for I know that you are a gracious and merciful God, slow to anger and abundant in loving kindness, one who relents from doing harm.
Amen. Here Jonah said, I know that you are a gracious and merciful God, slow to anger. Hallelujah. He knew God is slow to anger. But I will get angry just like this. I know you are God of mercy, slow to anger. I know everything. But I will get angry just like this. Amen. Hallelujah. Abundant in loving kindness, one who relents from doing harm. Hallelujah. I know you will do everything. That's why the few days before I went away from Nineveh. Hallelujah. I went away from Nineveh and I went to Tarsus. Hallelujah. I know you will do all this stuff. That's why I went away. Amen. Hallelujah. Now Jonah is blaming God. You are the reason for my backsliding. Hallelujah. Correct? Amen. Because he wanted God to do things according his wish. Amen. Hallelujah. There is an ego. There is a prestige issue. I preached, so you need to fulfill this word. Amen. Hallelujah. God can change his heart anytime. Amen. He is God. Hallelujah. Your duty is just a messenger duty. Amen. Hallelujah. Okay, for example, one FedEx man brought a letter to your house. You are not paying the mortgage, so you need to go away from this house. Okay, from the bank, the notice came. He came and delivered the notice. Hallelujah. That's it. His job is done. Then it's between you and your bank manager. Maybe the bank manager showed mercy to you to cancel that notice. He can allow you to stay in the house. When the next week, when the FedEx came, person, same messenger came to you, he cannot tell you, hey, why you guys are still staying here. Do you understand? Hello? Yes, yes, yes. Amen? Right? If I say FedEx, easily you are understanding. But we are failed to put ourselves in the place of Jonah. Our job is delivering the message. Hallelujah. We cannot bend God. Hallelujah. Because it's an ego problem now. I preached, my word needs to be fulfilled. Because what the people will think about me? What the people will think about? Hey, he's a false prophet. He told in 40 days the Jonah and Nineveh will be destroyed. But we are still alive. He's a false prophet. People will mark me like this. I don't want to hear all this stuff. Amen. Many times as a Christian, we have the prestige issue. We have the ego problem. Hallelujah. I don't care. I don't care how many people are coming to the church. I don't care how many people are saved. No. Whatever I preach, it has to be done. No. Hallelujah. You cannot become God to God. You are just a messenger. Hallelujah. He is the master. We are servant. Hallelujah. Our duty is to deliver the message. He can do whatever he wants to do. Hallelujah. Amen. If you see that chapter 3, the people of Nineveh, they never accused Jonah. Do you know that? That is the truth. They thought, we can come back to God. Maybe he will change his heart. He did not accuse Jonah, right? They respected Jonah. That's why they started to pray. They respected his word. He is a servant of God. He is a prophet. Hallelujah. Let us go back to God. That's the way they thought. But Jonah was upset. Hallelujah. Because his prestige issue. That's why first time he went away from the Lord. Amen. I know he won't do the things according to my wish. I don't want to stick on to his plan. Amen. If you want to stick on to God's plan, you need to come down. And you need to say, I am just a servant. I am just a servant. Hallelujah. Whatever you want to do, you do it, O God. I am ready. I am willing to do your will. I do not have any of my own ideas. Amen. Jonah had many own ideas. He thought, he wanted, the Nineveh needs to be destroyed. Because I preached. Because I went. I told. I. Hallelujah. When you have this thought of I, you will be upset with God. Amen. Hello. Amen. Amen. We need to think, I am just a messenger. He is God. I will do whatever he is asking me to do. Rest of the things I will leave it in his hand. Hallelujah. Amen. Okay. Verse 3.
Therefore now, O Lord, please take my life from me, for it is better for me to die than to live.
Hallelujah. This time, he changed the prayer. Amen. He did not go away from any place. Hallelujah. He did not want to take the ticket to go to Tarshish. Amen. Last time he tried. But it's more worse. So better he can kill me here. I don't want to go anywhere. Hallelujah. We can read the next verse. He prayed like this. Lord, kill me here.
Then the Lord said, is it right for you to be angry?
Hallelujah. Patiently he is asking. Is it right for you to be angry? Amen. Hallelujah. Next verse.
So Jonah went out of the city and sat on the east side of the city. There he made himself a shelter and sat under it in the shade till he might see what would become of the city.
See? Even though he knew God of mercy, God of loving kindness, right? Slow to anger, right? What he did? He put the tent against the city of Nineveh till he might see what would become of the city. Hallelujah. What kind of Jonah this? Adamant Jonah. Hallelujah. I will not move away from this place until I see Nineveh needs to be destroyed. Hallelujah. If you are adamant with God, he knows how to more adamant than you. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. The adamant quality, the character needs to go away from us. When you know the heart of God, he knew the heart of God. But he was very adamant. Right? Because things needs to be happen according my desire, according my wish, according my will. I don't want to go down. I don't want to compromise with my husband. No, it has to be done like this. I don't want to adjust with my wife. It has to be like this. No. You cannot be adamant. Hallelujah. Who did? Who was adamant? Who was he?
Prophet.
Who was he? chosen vessel like you and me. Who was he? Child of God like you and me. Children of God, many times we are very adamant. We don't want to adjust. We don't want to flexible. We will put the tent and we'll sit in the tent until we see the destroy of Nineveh. Hallelujah. Lot of prestige issue involved with this, Lord. Let me see whether you or me. That is called adamant. Hallelujah. Thank God. Only 3-4 more minutes. I thought today I can finish off Jonah. Amen. Shall you all stand?